Hello and welcome to another FOG video about Destiny 2. This, I think, shall be a quick one. Maybe not. I would like to discuss and give my thoughts on the following question. Could Halo Infinite kill Destiny 2? And sure, that's a question that's presented itself quite a number of times before. Games like Outriders, Cyberpunk, The Division, Borderlands, Marvel's Avengers, even Anthem. This question has been asked over and over and over again, and the answer thus far has pretty much always been no. Destiny simply cannot be killed by these subpar games, but I do think that this time it is a little more serious than ever before. Halo Infinite, could that be the game that, in a way, kills Destiny 2? Now, I want to start by clarifying what it is exactly that I'm saying here, because there's a lot of confused people out there that seem to misunderstand certain things that I say and questions that I pose, and tend to take a lot of it in quite literal terms. Because in reality, what this question actually relates to is the true popularity of Destiny 2. So basically, when I say kills Destiny 2, it should be pretty obvious that I don't mean an actual death to Destiny 2, that I'm fully aware Destiny 2 isn't just going to die in the sense that everyone's just gonna stop playing the game immediately and Bungie's gonna pull some sort of plug and the game's gonna be gone forever. No, that's definitely not what I'm saying. What I'm really saying, or what I'm really asking, is something like, will player count drop considerably with the release of Halo Infinite, making Destiny 2 less popular, putting a dent on Destiny 2's popularity? And would those players that have left later return to Destiny? Will PvP players leave Destiny 2 and move to Halo, seeing as the PvP in Destiny 2 isn't in the best of shapes, and the PvP in Halo looks absolutely amazing? I mean, what would that do to the Destiny 2 population? This is really what I'm asking, okay? I do think there is a degree of possibleness that Destiny 2 could really suffer with the release of a game like Halo Infinite, especially when not only does Halo Infinite look absolutely superb from what we've all seen, but also a huge chunk of the Destiny player base were originally from the old Halo games, who then came over to Destiny. But now that Destiny has quite literally been pretty much the same over and over and over and over for the last 6 or 7 years, we all now have a chance to go back to Halo and get to experience that awesome old school Halo gameplay that's now been brought in line and in quality with the very best shooters that we've ever seen. So yeah, I think a lot of the Destiny community will end up leaving Destiny 2 behind for a while. And maybe some will return, but maybe some won't. I think it's really going to depend on the sustainability of Halo. Another thing to take into consideration is that, for a brand new player, Destiny 2 has a huge amount of content and can be extremely addictive, especially if you play through the first hours or so of Destiny 2. The game will grab you, it'll pull you in, and there's really no escaping it after that. There's no denying that the mechanics are quite probably the best ever designed. But for players like me, who have been playing consistently since the very first day, there's no question most of us will go and try out Halo. A lot of us will likely be back to Destiny at some point, but there will be undoubtedly some players that won't go back, and they'll be able to break that addiction to Destiny by moving over to Halo. Now, as far as Destiny 2 itself right now, I definitely think it's in one of the best places it's ever been in. Maybe not for PvP, but in terms of PvE, it does feel great. And to be fair, the new trial system, although not perfect, does somewhat put PvP in a much better place than it has been for a long time, maybe the last 2 or 3 years. In any case, right now, we have a pretty good variety of activities. We finally have cross cosplay. We have a transmog system, albeit it's okay at best. I'd say we also have a pretty well balanced sandbox, which is kept feeling somewhat fresh due to the regular changes made by Bungie. Basically, all in all, there's a lot of good positive things currently in Destiny 2. And of course, the PlayStation players will, for the most part, stay with Destiny 2, because Halo is only available on Xbox and PC. Now, there are also a lot of negatives, which can certainly push players away and towards other, newer, interesting games. In this particular case, that would be Halo. One of the bigger issues that I personally have with Destiny 2 is the content vault. And yes, I know, a lot of you are happy and on board with it, and you don't mind that Bungie work this way, and as far as what Bungie state as the reason for it, I understand, I absolutely understand. But nonetheless, for me, this method or this model is rather scammy. It just is. Mainly because I do not like paying for the same things more than once. What I mean by that is, if I paid for the Destiny 1 game, which of course came with the moon in it as part of it, but then 3 or 4 years later, Bungie decide to make some alterations to it and release it into Destiny 2 again as DLC and charge me for it. Yeah, I can't say I'm happy about that. And my fear, which is literally coming to life, is that this is what Bungie will continue to do to try and prolong the lifespan of their game. I don't want Bungie to use the game's nostalgia as a way to sell us products that they've already sold to us in the past. I just think that's a con. And I'm not happy about it. And it certainly makes me have negative feelings towards the game, which in turn automatically pushes me towards other games that could potentially give me a newer, more conventional experience. Another thing that bugs me, which falls into the same exact category pretty much, is the Witch Queen expansion. They're basically using the Gjallarhorn as a way to charge the most insane and ridiculous amount for the Bungie 30th Anniversary Bundle Edition or whatever it is. I mean, $100? $100? Just because it comes with the Gjallarhorn? Are you kidding me? How much more of a scam can this get? They're worse than Activision. And this is proof right here. I mean, let me put it this way. I bought the original Destiny game, paid for that, which of course came with the Gjallarhorn, right? It was part of the loot pool. Now, from what I remember, they then decided to sunset it, and then they re-released it as part of the Rise of Iron expansion, I think, as the Iron Gjallarhorn, which of course we paid for that expansion again. So that's basically twice that, in a way, we paid for the Gjallarhorn. And now, yet again, if we want it, we have to pay a third time for it. But not only that, this time, the cost is truly insane. And yeah, sure, I realize there will be other content involved in the transaction, but what I'm saying, in essence, Bungie are using the Gjallarhorn to justify and sell us their overpriced version of the Witch Queen DLC, which is basically a way to get more money out of their players. And that is just simply not right. That is not okay. But I am sure that many Destiny players will just swallow hard and pay the money, feeding this new hungry monster that Bungie is turning into. We also saw how, when the Halo multiplayer came out, a lot of players praised how awesome it was. And I'm pretty sure that, in one way or another, it brought a bit of concern and worry into the Bungie realm. I say that because, as soon as the beta came out and people stated how much they loved it, Bungie took to Twitter to say there were a lot of plans to revamp PvP, and that they were working on lots of things. And they announced that there would be new and old maps coming back, and that they were working on things that they couldn't yet really tell us about. I mean, is that a coincidence? Probably not. What that tells me is that Bungie are indeed worried and fully realize that this is no joke. I honestly think they went, we need to sort out PvP ASAP. I think they panicked after seeing all the positiveness from players, and then they thought, if we don't sort out PvP, we're gonna lose a bunch of players, including the big YouTubers. Because obviously, most of the Destiny YouTubers are PvP players. And if Halo is bigger and better in that space, Bungie will probably be a little bit screwed. I mean, it all makes a lot of sense, in my head at least. Because when you look at it, they stated they're only going to release two maps for Season 16 with Witch Queen, and then in like an old map, like 4 months later? It don't sound right, because I'm pretty certain it wouldn't take that long for them to make a couple of new PvP maps. It's almost like they're scrambling to get these maps ready in time, because they in fact didn't have any plans to do any of this until they saw the Halo beta feedback. But hey, maybe I'm completely wrong on this. But I do honestly believe that if Bungie don't really shape up and try to do something good with Crucible, a lot of the player base on PC and Xbox will go to Halo. Halo is looking like it could really do some damage to Destiny 2, especially with the PvP community. And as I said, I really think Bungie are worried, and although it won't kill Destiny, obviously, it could certainly be the game that thus far will have the biggest impact on player numbers. I don't think there's any doubt in my mind, and in a lot of other people's minds, that this is the case. I, for one, am rather looking forward to Halo Infinite. Plus, Witch Queen will not be out until February anyway, and there's no new season or content in Destiny until then. And sure, I realize a lot of players will just take a break from Destiny and maybe then return for the Witch Queen DLC, but I do honestly believe that if Bungie don't start trying to actually do positive things for its player base and stop trying to pretty much screw us all over, little by little, players will just stop returning. There's quite a lot of good games out there where the developers or publishers don't try and continuously screw their players over and over. I'm sorry, but I do think what they're doing with the 30th anniversary edition is absolutely despicable. The worst of the worst that they've ever done. I honestly believe that Bungie really need to think twice about their approach to the future of Destiny 2. They absolutely need to start taking into consideration that there are a lot of games that are coming out that could slowly or rapidly make Destiny 2 fall apart. Not only due to the state of PvP or the recreation and recycling of content, which inevitably makes it feel even more repetitive, but also their practices, their policies, when it comes to how they treat their own players. So, to finish off, I don't think Halo's gonna kill Destiny 2, but I do think that there will be an impact to the game, and I do think that Bungie are more worried than ever before, and that's what I think. Now, I'd like to know what you think. I'm certainly curious to know on this one. Leave your views, leave your comments below. Thank you very much for watching. See you on the next one. A goodbye!